Amazon PPC can be straightforward when you set the right goals tailored to your business needs. In this video, you will learn the importance of setting realistic advertising objectives that align with your specific business demands rather than adopting a generic one-size-fits-all strategies. And in case you are looking for a tool for your PPC optimization, check out the Amalyze tool. You will find the link below in the video description.
Hello, Christian. I'm really happy to have you back on Orange Klik channel to talk about Amazon's PPC. And specifically today, we're going to go and dive into some of the PPC problems that Amazon sellers are facing. And you're suggesting some ideas and solutions how they could overcome it from the standpoint of their own business and not just some general knowledge around PPC. So we're going to do that today. But before, as always, let's first start with your introduction. And also, could you give us a brief overview of what Amalyze is and what do you usually do to help Amazon sellers?
Yeah, hello out there, or as I normally say, hello together. My name is Christian Kelm. I'm working in the Amazon enterprises for sellers, vendors, and agencies since over 10 years now. And we as a tool offering unique SEO features and functions. And on the other side, we are also focusing on Amazon PPC since 10 years. But after the big technology shift of Amazon with Amazon marketing stream data, that means you now have access to hourly based data. We develop new ideas and also features from that. And what we are normally doing is giving the opportunities to manage your account and your business in the ways you want to handle them. We don't want to show you a plan of action or something like that. We just want to remind you that there's more opportunities out there and we are going to showing them. And if you're using them or not, it's just a matter of your mindset.
Very good. I know you prepared the presentation for us as well to kind of go through everything you have planned to share with us and with the sellers today. So we're ready for that. But I just wanted to remind all of the viewers that if you're watching this interview and you have any questions about anything Christian is sharing, then feel free to leave your questions as comments under the video, because then we can ask Christian to come back to the YouTube video and also give you some additional insights as well. So Christian, yeah, go ahead, share your screen, and I'm eager to learn from you as always.
So we will start in the situation of talking about problems, ideas, and solutions for Amazon PPC in 2024. And as said, we will start with a simple problem, or as I would say, that is one of the simplest problems. Of course, everybody is talking about funnel, and how to use it. The problem here is, from my point of view, on the one side, we have awareness, and on the other side, the impressions. Normally, when you're putting together consideration and clicks, and at the end, purchases. That looks normally really clear, but from my point of view, I'm also purchasing products because I've seen them. I'm going directly to add to cart, and so there's a lot of mixed behavior of customers in that funnel. And in the end, we just want more sales. That is normally the idea behind it. And what I'm seeing very often is that everybody just want to grow the funnel and build it bigger and bigger and bigger. But what is happening at the end, we are not seeing more sales. We are just seeing a bigger funnel. And that is a problem. And to make it clear, it's just funny. But maybe you know it, but out of over 100,000 customers, survey said 60% had already bought by mistake in the awareness phase. 30% are confused consideration with conditional. And 30% of the customers receive packages but don't know what's inside. So that's a typical normal day worldwide. We are receiving packages, but we really, really purchasing day after day after day. And we as an end customer, we really don't know if we are in the awareness, consideration, or purchase phase of a funnel. That is a problem. So at the end, we are always back to ACoS. ACoS is the dominating KPI in every Amazon ad strategy. Sometimes it's switching to ACoS, but let's say we are here down to ACoS. What you normally need, and you have to think about it, that every part of your whole strategy, of your whole funnel, needs specific goals. And for that specific strategies on goals, you need KPIs. And the problem here is normally everybody is bringing it down to ACoS. But when you're only looking for impressions, ACoS isn't a part of it. Of course, without any clicks, you have no costs. Without any costs, you will not see any sales in the end. And so you will not see an ACoS behind it when your goal is just to build a bigger funnel with more and more impressions. And so we have to rethink a few things. So we are going directly to the idea behind it. Normally, the idea should be really, really easy. Your bids can raise and must increase when your conversion rate is, for example, here in that case, nearly doubling up. It's absolutely fine. Nobody will discuss about that. But with the still same ACoS, of course, that should be the final goal, to get more and more sales or better conversion rate or handle the higher CPCs on Amazon, but still fitting your goals. But a lot of problems then appear when it gets more and more complex. Of course, you have rising costs, but what is the reason behind it? And for example, you have set it up more and more targets that could be ASINs, keywords, categories. You're setting up more and more ads. That means you will see more costs at the end, followed by a rising ACoS. That's absolutely a normal situation. When the customer then decides to purchase a cheaper product or you are using a coupon or whatever, you can double up your ACoS. That is the normal interaction problem of Amazon, and we are going to talk about that in details. Of course, what we have seen a lot and a lot of times is sometimes one thing is happening. You are reaching your goals, setting 5% ACoS, but over the time you're losing your impressions, your clicks. You were saving a lot of costs, of course, but you are also losing more orders and the revenue at the end. Of course, you have miscalculated your advertising goals and you have lost your permission to play on Amazon. That's the reason why everybody is talking about PPC like the pay-to-play game at the end. And you have to figure out how to handle it and how to work under that mixed circumstances. So the first and simplest solution from our point of view is really easy. We can start with ACoS as that. And when you bring it down, it's just bid divided through conversion rate multiplied with average price. That is really, really simple. And if you're not into that, it's no problem. Here's just a reminder, ad spend divided through ad revenue, and the rest of it is just mathematics behind it. So we will come back at the end to that normal formula. And now let's start. Let's enter some calculations into it. Let's say we have a $25 product, conversion rate 10%, our ACoS goal is 10%, and our price for the CPC for the bid is 25 cents. Now the ad is not working really well, and I don't know why, but the normal reflex of every seller out there is nearly the same. The first reflex is, the ads are not working, raise the bids. But with that situation, with that higher bids, your ACoS in that example will double up. Of course, you're not changing the conversion rate. You're not changing the average order value or the price of your product. And now you're not seeing only bad ads. The ads gets worse. So that's the problem behind it. And then the second reflex appears. Everybody is like, okay, set a coupon, set a voucher for it. Just lower the price. Everything will get better. But when you're seeing a more rising in ACoS, that is a problem. You can solve that problem, of course, absolutely. Of course, the ACoS should stay the same. We want our 10% ACoS. but for which conversion rate? Of course, we all know it. If we are setting higher CPCs, lower our prices, the conversion rate will of course explode to 25%. But that will not happen, as we all know. And the problem here is that everybody is misjudging the gaming around the normal ACoS mathematics behind it. And if you're changing something, you will always change the left side of the formula, which means your ACoS. So, what is a possible solution? First of all, we can always start with our ACoS dream goals. And that is a really example of one of our customers. He said, okay, ACoS of 20%, absolutely wonderful. If you can reach that goal, perfect. We have recalculated through everything and we figured out, okay, so that means the CPC in max could be 60 cents, euro cent, dollar cent, it doesn't matter. It's about the numbers behind it. Product price, $30 conversion rate, ACoS, you can see it here. And then you just have to put it into the formula and everything is fine. The problem now was really, really simple, and I've seen it for freelancers, for agencies, or also internal when you're giving your goals to a member of your company. The ACoS goal set it in the tool for the agency, for the freelancer, or ours is 15. Just to reach your goal, you're saying, yeah, I don't trust really into that tool or agency. I will set the bar really low. So if we are not directly getting that 15%, I'm fine because my real goal is 20%. The problem here is, from mathematical side, that is a big, big problem. As you know, with 20% ACoS, we started with 60 cent, and now we are down to 45 cent. And so you start to work against your own goals while using the wrong communication, and you're not trusting the tool, the agency, your own members of a company or whatever. Then the third problem here is the initial bids. We have looked into the initial bids of that campaigns and ad groups, and we have figured out it was set to 30% ACoS. The problem here is really simple. When you recalculate it, you will see, okay, the starting bids were $1.20 with a normal goal of getting 20% with 60 cents or at least 50% ACoS with 45 cents. So now it starts to becoming problematic when you're not really focused on your goals and trust everybody in the line of advertising with correct numbers. So what we have done was really simple. We have questioned our customer, what is really your goal? What is wrong? What is happening at the moment? What's your problem? And what the real thing behind it was really, really simple. It was end of season and he had a lot of overstock and he need to get rid of that overstock, and an ACoS of 30% will really, really fit and solve the problems. And so we were down to 90 cents CPC max at the end. So the normal idea and the solution behind it is really simple. Please make sure that you understand what you can afford versus what is the given specifications for a tool, freelancer, or member of a company. What is your initial bid? Of course, the initial bid has a high impact for the following weeks or nearly months in your advertising. And please make sure to understand your actual needs. So don't mix it up in the wrong way. You're seeing the bid calculations directly here. We are talking for example, from differences of 45 cents to $1.20. And that is really, really a big mistake to don't know what you really want to reach as a goal. With that, problems comes ideas and solutions. So especially when it comes to ACoS. Of course, The problem here is really, really simple. What is the average? The average of what? Normally, you're working, for example, for an advertising ACoS of a whole account, or for a portfolio, or a specific number of campaigns, or when it comes really nerdy, maybe a few ad groups have to reach a specific goal. But we, at the end, nobody's going down on target level. So what I'm showing you here is two different goals. Both have to reach the ACoS goal of 20%. And you're seeing down here on the X-axis 9,000 targets, and Y is showing the ACoS. Both tools have reached 20% on average. But the problem here is really simple. The blue tool is working on average on the whole account. But so you are having a lot of money invested in the wrong ways. Absolutely unprofitable sales, just that you have sales. That's not the idea behind it. But the problem then starts, because on the other side, to calculate that on average, you need a lot of over-profitable targets with absolutely low A cost to, at the end, reach the goal to make sure that these high unprofitable sales are on average recalculated to 20% on average. And the problem here is really, really simple. Only 0.56% of the targets really, really reached the ACoS goal of 20%. And when you're looking directly into it, yes, here, there's the little arrow for it. We are the orange tool. The orange tool and our idea is focused on each and every keyword. And not to reach it on average in the campaign or in the portfolio or in the account. We're adjusting your bids for each and every target exactly for your specific goals. And so we achieved specific goals for each area and for every target in that area will at the end look like that. Of course, as we all know, the hockey stick effect in PPC sometimes makes sense. High ACoS for attacking competitors, or you have to push or launch specific products. They have to be unprofitable at the beginning. Of course, you only will see costs at the beginning and no sales cost to the attribution of Amazon. But what I really want is to make sure that every part of my ad strategy is following my goals exactly for each keyword. I don't want to see any hockey sticks that reach a goal on average. I want to see achieved ACoS goals for every target. And the idea is at the end that we can go back to advertising strategies where we can set specific goals for keywords or specific targets for ad groups, for campaigns. And at the end, we will know that every target under that strategy will follow that simple rule and don't get over and under profitable sales that reach at the end in specific average. To finish that, we have built up specific solutions. Of course, one thing is missing at the end. ACoS is not static. If you want to see any ACoS insights in your ad console, you always have to set a specific date from to. Without any dates, you will never have an ACoS shown in the ad console. And the problem here is really simple. If you don't really good with your ads and you will look like that in 14-day windows and you're saying that, bad ads are bad, you're maybe trying to change something or you're going a bit more back from the problem. You can change the period under consideration, for example, as simple as for the last 30 days. And you're seeing it directly here. If you're looking at 13 days versus 30 days, the ACoS will sink from 40 to 32. When we look at the end, for example, for 90-day window to judge our ads, we will see, oh, we even don't have any problem. there is no need to change a bit. And especially for slow movement products, only selling once a week or whatever, that is the best solution to strategically reach your ACoS goals. And with good data management behind it and the technology benefits of Amazon Marketing Stream data, you can at the end set specific dynamic or static periods to judge your ads, especially for your products and for the behavior in that period under consideration, and not the gambling like you may be knowing it. At the end, Amazon is coming with a little problem around. That is not typically an Amazon problem. It's typically a customer problem. And the idea here is, what time period do you consider for your decisions? We as end customers have different behaviors when it comes to diapers or vacuum cleaners. If the diapers are empty, we need new diapers. Okay? Immediately. Yeah? And when it comes to vacuum robots, we maybe will go to the next market and have a look on it, to a portal online to trying to make sure, is it that really the best? Or sometimes we just have to wait for the end of the month. Of course, we don't have any budget to buy it. And the time between a click and a purchase is really, really impactful when it comes to Amazon. In the Amazon Marketing Stream data, you see the data points for Amazon attribution, not Amazon attribution, Amazon ACoS attribution, 1 day, 7 days, 14 days, or even 30 days. And that's what it's look like. What's looking like, sorry. And now let's talk about setting attributions, but for what exact? So the simple idea behind it is really easy. We have one target. It doesn't matter if it's an ACE in a category, keyword, or whatever. We see a number of impressions behind it. We see a number of clicks behind it. We have a price for the product and an ACoS goal. We want to achieve that ACoS goal. If you decided to only go with the ACoS attribution 1 day, you can only bid 17 cents. With 5 sales, 3.33 the conversion rate in that 1 day, the only bid that is possible is 17 cents. If you are waiting 6 more days, and for example, 2 more sales are coming up in that 6 days, you are able to set a bid of 24 cents. That is really more than 17 cents. We don't have to talk about that. But let's talk about the next week. Only 1 sale more in 7 days, and I can set bids over 10% higher than before. Normally, the seller central attribution for sponsored products is 7 days. We know that vendors have had 14 days, so they normally have better ACoS goals because we are seeing more and more ads. The problem here is, especially when we are coming then to the 40 days, your attribution window of Amazon is closed after 7 days. Every sale then you only see in your seller center as an organic sale. You're not seeing them as an ad-attributed sale. But with that technology behind, with Amazon Marketing Stream, we can make that possible. And now the funny things begin. Of course, your competitor is maybe going with that 7 days window. Another competitor is maybe also using that feature and going with a 14 days window. And you, without changing your ACoS goal and anything, you can invest more money. Of course, you can set a higher bid just course to the attribution window you are using for 40 days. And I think in that technology surrounding Amazon is offering now since nearly 1 year, it's absolutely necessary to switch the own mindset from gambling with bids to really understand that there are two new numbers in it. Period under consideration is the one, and ACoS attribution is the other one. And the third is the setting the bids on target level for the exact ACoS and not on average for the campaign, on average for portfolio, on average for whole account. There are more possibilities out there thanks to Amazon and Amazon marketing stream data. So to sum up, in 2024, even that we have April and May, we will return to self-determined settings and achieving advertising goals. And that is, from my point of view, one of the most impactful goals you can set in that year.
Okay, Christian, thank you so much for giving us an overview of how sellers should actually consider their ACoS and set goals for themselves and understand how different goals impact the strategies they can have. But one question, you said like it's very important to set goals from the point of view of your own business and what you need to do. But how often do you talk with sellers or see sellers who actually don't know how to phrase what should be their real goal? Because I think it was also like one of your examples. I think that's quite often that sellers don't know actually how to know where they should be heading. So I don't know, do you have any advice like what questions they should ask for themselves or how they could like be more precise with setting their advertising goals?
Yeah, on the one side, it's really simple. So nearly everybody is struggling with that. We are going back to the mathematics. So on the one side, it's just the economic calculation behind it. So you cannot set $5 bids for a 15 euro product without a conversion rate of 100, 200 or 300 or whatever to be at the end profitable. So on the one side, there's that economic calculation that we are going through with our customers to figuring out, do they really understand? On the other side, as you have seen it in our slides, we have an eye on conversion rates, targets, average order value, and you're seeing the customer behavior of your clients. So what we had last was a pair of clothes. And one was with two pair of clothes, so four clothes. And there was a variation which also shown one pair of clothes. And as the season changed for garden, the custom behavior switched from two pairs to one pair. And the average order value dropped from 60 euro to 30 euro. So what we are trying to do is building a maximum of transparency for your advertising to make sure don't get in panic. Of course, normally, even if you can calculate correctly, you will follow that path of reflexes like, oh, set the bids higher, lower the price of a product, but you're not looking at the problem itself, lower conversion rates, average order value that you're losing or whatever. And then you can reinvestigate what is the problem, and then you can start to solve that problem, change the main advertised ASIN from the double to the one pack and all that stuff. And last but not least, that is the typical problem. Normally, you're not able to name a goal, for example, higher rankings, or I want to see all my products on the first page for these and these keywords. From that point of view, we're normally starting to get rid of ACoS. The first scenario behind it is, what do you want to pay to be number one? What do you want to invest to be number one, two, three, and show your organic results under that keyword? And when we can go through that questions, we will find solutions. And then normally the ACoS, for example, could be 1,000%, 10,000%, or whatever. Because your strategic goal is being number one. Or your strategic goal is just get rid of your overstock. Yeah, of course, to the fees and to the problems, you need cash flow and whatever. And so we are investing a lot of time into direct consulting to really figuring out what they want, as we added in the second example of 20%, 50%, 40%, 30% ACoS. And it took us nearly half an hour to figuring out the real problem is overstock. And the goal was really different than from the settings. That is what we are doing. On the one side, economic mathematic, figuring out what the goal is, and when trying to consult our customers how you can achieve that goals with that tool or with that mindset or with Amazon itself.
Okay, very good. And I believe, like, if I think about like the things you covered within the presentation, so one thing was average order value. About conversion rate, we hear, I think, people talk about much more often, like, what are the things, like, people know that they have to have good conversion rates, they have to work on improving the conversion rates. But let's talk about briefly about average order value. So you mentioned now, when replying to my last question, about different variations. So maybe can you give us some examples? So what are the options usually sellers have to kind of increase the average order value? And this is kind of already, I think, more holistic view of the advertising as well. It's not just like, you know, we're not just purely focusing on like keywords or bids. It's actually much more. It's about the offer as well, right?
Absolutely. The main problems is when you're advertising a product in a variation, you set options for the customer to purchase another product. When you don't have the same price for all the products in the variation, the problems are made by yourself. Or when you have really at the end one top color in advertising, but you have cheap colors in that variation too, you are making your advertising shitty at the end. The other side is in the attribution window of Amazon, there are normally all sales of the brand. So it could also be that you're advertising a cheap product and you have a higher average order value. Of course, everybody is then purchasing other or more expensive products. But the easiest way to get a higher average order value are the EBC and A+ premium charts. You can directly include upselling and cross-selling. But make sure that you're not offering just the more expensive product. Try to be the next product in the add to cart. So when you're showing a specific what we can talk about it. Yeah, if you're selling pens, you have to sell paper. Pens and papers, and show them on your product. We had a cool talk in Prague by myself about building solutions is the normal brand building, and you need to make sure that your customer will come back on the one side or directly purchase more products of your brand, because you are offering a solution for a problem and you fingered until the end. So a trash can is only as good as the trash bags you purchase for them. And so you normally have to think more holistic when it comes to that. And then Amazon has released additional product sets, I think is the English name for it. So there's a complete new part on the PDPs. It's rolled out in your backend. You go to A+ and A+ premium, and you will find it direct to brand story. You will find additional product sets. These are not virtual bundles. This is another cool way of showing your relevant products up to 4 or 5 different ASINs directly to that ASIN the customer is on, and there are directly add to cart banners on it. So one cool LinkedIn comment to that was, you need to build more real estate on Amazon. And when it comes to higher average order value, we are not talking about the SERPs, we are talking about the PDPs, how it is possible to gain more and more real estate on the PDP to make sure the next purchase is always your product. That means brand protection ads. That means show your necessary next products, connected accessories or whatever to your product. Show your brand, make it possible for the customer to go into the brand store and find a brand store. Conversion rates, average cart values are much higher in the brand stores. Make sure you're using the brand story to show products and connect it to the brand store. Use the tables in the A+ premium. And of course, the new settings of additional product sets, which is at the end the easiest way to get a higher average order value. Of course, if you're advertising cheap products, normally the purchase behavior will still be cheap, but when you're offering 3 or 4 or 5 necessary connected products of your brand, hopefully, then you will see better results. And the conclusion, you will see better results in your ads. Of course, when the market is with an average order value of 10 and you are going with 12 or 15 at the end, you will have an absolutely benefit in your CPCs and you will see it directly.
Okay, great. Well, I think sellers have to rewatch the last part because I think you shared so many good points to answer my questions, like where sellers can actually work and kind of put in effort to, yeah, I should say, take as much space with their products, but not just random products, but relevant and necessary products to each other on their product detail pages. So yeah, thanks for the additional tips. So Christian, to kind of wrap up with today's interview, can you once more highlight what are the main tools that Amalyze offers for Amazon sellers? And also, what's the best way to reach out to you if anyone has questions about the tools and would like to learn more? Of course, there are links also down in the video description below as well.
Yeah, first of all, we are showing normally ideas. Our part at the beginning is showing ideas and filling that with knowledge and building up problems, ideas, and solutions. Amalyze itself is a software service tool for the main functions of SEO with complete listing builder and all that monitoring projects and all that stuff. And on the other side, we are offering a lot of PPC solutions. And you can find us on YouTube, also a German-speaking channel and an English-speaking channel. And of course, if you want to directly reach to me, just write me an email, ck@amalyze.com or via LinkedIn. Or we will see us next year in Prague when you can wait so long.
Exactly. The new dates for the European Site Conference for next year have already been announced. So yeah, if you would like to see Christian in person, most likely he will be in Prague in March 2025, as he was at our event this year, actually as a speaker. So yeah, I was lucky enough to see you in person also just a little bit a time ago and see you also perform on stage where you gave also a very useful speech for the sellers. So yeah, I want to thank you for taking time to come here to share your knowledge with us and with our YouTube audience, and I hope to see you soon again.
Thanks for your time.
I do hope that this video was helpful for you and it will help you a little bit to give ideas how you can optimize your PPC, and you can try these strategies on your Amazon business. And if you want to use Amalyze to optimize your Amazon advertising campaigns, you will find the link below in the description. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit like and subscribe buttons. Also, if you have additional questions, leave them in the comment section below. And now I recommend you to watch other video where you will hear some valuable PPC insights from one of the top 100 Amazon sellers.